Second and third grade students in Lakewood, Ohio, and their teacher, Ms. Bluemel, traveled back through time as they investigated the history of Birdtown, Lakewood's oldest neighborhood. With the help of Mrs. Mazie Adams, the executive director of the Lakewood Historical Society, the children gathered photos of the area, researched dates and historical information, conducted oral histories, and explored the neighborhood itself.
Birdtown is a 10-block area in the southeast corner of Lakewood that was created in the early 1890s for the employees of the National Carbon Factory. In 1891, the National Carbon Company purchased 155 acres of land at West 117th Street and Madison Avenue. 1 year later, the factory buildings were up and running. At one time, over 2,600 people worked there.
When the factory first opened, the executives built large homes in the new town of Lakewood, but the workers had to travel long distances to get to their jobs because there are no streetcar lines nearby. Many workers walked the road in horse-drawn wagons, sometimes over muddy or icy streets. So National Carbon started the Pleasant Hill Land Company to create a new neighborhood near the factory. In 1894, Pleasant Hill Land Company platted 8 narrow streets and 424 small lots. The area was originally named Carbon District, but was also called Bird's Nest, Ducktown, and then Birdtown.
National Carbon owned all this property, so what they decided to do was they platted it out. They made lots. Each little section there, the little things are called lots, where people would build their houses on or have a builder build it for them. And then they could go to work real close to National Carbon.
5 out of 9 streets in Birdtown were named after birds. Plover is a small shorebird. Quail-like open spaces. Thrush are small birds with large eyes. The robin's song is the first sign of spring. Larks have a wonderful song. The other streets are Halstead, Dowd, McGee, and Madison Avenue.
Birdtown was settled by a lot of people who came from the same parts of Europe. We all came from somewhere. And the people who lived in Birdtown for years and years and years, and still, there's still lots of second and third generation families in Birdtown. They came from a certain part of Europe. They came from Slovakia and the Ukraine, which I think we now just say Ukraine. And they came from parts of Poland.
My parents also came from Slovakia. Our mothers are sisters. And my mother came here first and was married. And then when her mom wanted to come over, my dad sponsored her. And this is the affidavit, and it puts everything on here, how much money my father had and where he lived and how many people were in his family, and that he was going to sponsor her mom.
This Eastern European heritage influenced the churches, architecture, businesses, and other aspects of everyday life in Birdtown. There are 4 remaining churches in Birdtown that were created by these early immigrants. St. Gregory, St. Nicholas, St. Cyril and Methodius, and St. Hedwig. Many of these congregations began in private homes or basements, then grew large enough to build beautiful churches. Lakewood's oldest church structure was built as St. Peter and Paul Lutheran Church, which then became Calvin United Presbyterian, and now is Lakewood Baptist Church.
And Christmas time, any of the holidays, Christmas, Easter, all the churches would be ringing their bells.
I was going to say that.
And it was just perfect. I mean, you knew something as special was happening.
The immigrants purchased property from the Pleasant Hill Land Company and built their own homes. Some people used Eastern European style in the construction of their new homes.
Because our house was attached to his store in the front. Got that? The store was in the front, the house was in the back. And all these people lived in the house. My mom and dad, my brother and I, my grandma, my grandpa, my uncle, my aunt, their children, my uncle, my aunt, their children. We were all one big happy family.
Most Birdtown homes had small front yards, open porches, and no driveways. People built single and double family homes and multi-unit residences. Many of the homes had attached businesses.
These brick houses, most of them were built by people who came over from Eastern Europe. They brought over their type of architecture and how things looked back home. They sort of incorporated those ideas into their homes. And so that's why there's a lot of interesting brick work in the neighborhood.
My father came over, I mean, he was a young man then. He came over in 1903 and he married a girl that he met here. See, they were both from Czechoslovakia. They met in Birdtown. When they got married, they were only 18 and 19. They bought a house that had a storefront, and then they had the home in the back of it. And they raised their four children there, well, six children in the end. So that's an old, old house, but they have kept it painted up, and I bet there are a lot of people living in there. And I was telling you that it had a storefront. Now, it doesn't, they made this over into a home, but they don't run a store there now. But think of this as almost, it was 95 years ago.
Birdtown was unique because the businesses were mixed in with the homes.
They had everything in the store. All from little knickknacks and clothes and
sewing equipment
yeah. And hair products and whatever you needed, you could find in the dime store.
There was a store on every corner. We had barber shops there, we had dairies, we had a grocery store, a lot of grocery stores. And you didn't have to go to the mall or anything, you just went down the street and go to the grocery store.
There were also banks, garages, funeral homes, meat markets, and bars. For recreation, residents could go to bowling alleys, dance halls, and the Royal Movie Theater.
When we went to the movies, they got dishes. These are from Royal Theater.
Oral Federal, Lakewood's oldest locally owned bank, first opened on Plover and then moved to Madison Avenue. Later it became Home Federal Savings Bank. Timothy Lasky renovated the old bank for his accounting business.
And Grandpa was a cobbler, which means he made shoes or he repaired shoes.
The first department store Lakewood had was on the corner of Madison and McGee, and it was called Shimmer Brothers.
And at Christmas time when I was a little girl, my brother took me on a sled up there to look at the window at Christmas. That was the big display. We didn't go downtown to Higbee's or whatever. We went to see Shimmer Brothers.
Fire destroyed the store on August 16, 1962. An apartment building now occupies the site of the original department store.
It was the biggest fire Lakewood ever saw. It burned for a couple of days. They couldn't put the fire out. So that was a big cornerstone of Birdtown.
There was the organ grinder man that would come up and down the street. This was unbelievable. This fellow had a monkey, and then he had a little organ grinder, and he, you know, like you do with the wheel, and the monkey would dance. And of course, this man got his income from pennies. So you give them a penny or two, and but they would walk up and down the streets. Organ grinder man, a greengrocer, the paper rags man, paper rags. He'd call out, paper rags, paper rags.
There is one school in Birdtown, and that was Harrison. It was originally called the South School. It was built in 1896, I believe. It was one of the oldest schools in Lakewood. It started out as a one-room schoolhouse. It then developed into Harrison Schools, which was the first two-room brick schoolhouse. There they added on additions, and I believe it reached its peak density, which had 390 students, in 1940.
In 2006, the old Harrison School on Quail was torn down to make way for a bigger and more modern building. Many of the churches in Birdtown operated parochial schools as well. Recent immigrants attended Americanization and English language classes at Harrison Night School. Lakewood Day Nursery was created with the help of National Carbon to assist working mothers with childcare. Because Birdtown residents could find almost everything they needed in their neighborhood, most did not own cars. Instead, they walked or rode in streetcars.
Birdtown represents a lot of Lakewood, and it is important to learn about the development of those type of areas and to maintain the historical significance of those buildings. Birdtown is very old, Lakewood is very old, but it is important that we keep that integrity of those buildings and we don't knock them down, and we try and save them and learn from the history that they can give us.
Although National Carbon has changed names, becoming Union Carbide, UCAR, now GraphTech, and the Pleasant Hill land allotment has changed significantly, Birdtown remains a unique neighborhood with fascinating stories to tell.